do solemnly swear
that I will be faithful, and bear true allegiance, to the Federal Republic of Nigeria, that I will preserve,
protect,
and defend the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. So help me God.
As Commissioner,
I,
Mark Chukwuemeka Okoye,
do solemnly swear.
That in the service of Anambra State of Nigeria,
as a commissioner,
I will be faithful,
and bear true allegiance
to the Federal Republic of Nigeria,
at all times. I will not discriminate
on the basis of religion,
tribe, sex.
Sex,
cult,
or status,
or practice any form of partiality
in the performance of my duties.
I will always place service to the state
and public above personal interests.
Realizing that the public office is a public trust.
That I always perform my official duties diligently.
And efficiently.
I will not engage or be involved in any activity. In conflict either directly or indirectly with this oath.
I will, in the performance of my official duties,
I will always not corrupt others.
Or aid or abet corruption in any of its facets. I will always follow the path of justice.
Honesty and concord. Amongst all the people of Anambra State and Nigeria in all I do.
I will always, in the discharge of my official duties,
comply with the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria,
and all applicable laws
to the Greater Anambra State.
I will not directly or indirectly communicate,
or reveal to any person,
any matter which shall be brought under my consideration,
or shall become known to me in the discharge of my duties.
Anambra Central, I want to thank the Executive Governor, and his entire team for this honor that has been done to us via Mac. I want to assure you all that for whatever Mac has done to end this, I want to assure you that the confidence that the government has imposed on him and all of you, Mac is going to surpass whatever he has done to end it. And let me say that I don't really know how to talk, how to thank the executive governor. The only thing I can adduce to what is happening today is his, because of his background as a corporate person, because in, you all know in this country, it's very rare to identify and give people the opportunity to showcase or try to show what they can do. What am I saying? Merit is always at the back. Mark is not a politician. Mark is a technocrat, and the governor identified him and gave him all the opportunity to do and showcase that he has something to offer. I want to assure the governor, the entire team today, that I am sure of words, but I want to assure you guys that today marks the beginning of so many radical changes, starting from wherever we have been and where we should be. The governor has done so much for Mark, and it's their time for the entire Dumu Kosha. We owe him, and we owe the entire team, total allegiance, total loyalty, and whatever else. So on behalf of all of us, everybody that is here has one link. Mark's in-laws, Mark's aunties and uncles, Nick Okoye, we're all here. I can tell you, we've always been ambassadors of this government. God will bless you. I'm glad you're here. Thank you very much.
She's no longer sitting at the bar
in Nigeria at the age of 30. Merits this honor. Mike has been a member of this great team from inception. He was part of the team that worked on the blueprint, and which encompasses the 12 enablers and the 4 pillars. And Mike has been consistent in all the assignments that he's been given to be able to move the process. You know, and he's a very numerate fellow, very well read. I don't need to go the press, you'll find out those details as you publish, you know, but he's a very well-read fellow. And the last program he just finished last year was in Harvard, you know, and he's been a great contributor here. What we're trying to show is that merits work. We don't give appointments because of who you are, or not. We check what you can do, and all of you here can attest to the fact that Mark is an accomplished fellow when it comes to both financial issues, strategy, the budget things that we've done so well, mapping out the budgets to ensure that year on year we are doing well on the ratios and what have you. So he deserves that. So congratulations. We have enough time now. I just received a call from the Honourable Minister. So let's bring them in.
I've just been confirmed as the Commissioner for Economic Planning, Budget and Development Partners of Anambra State by His Excellency, the Governor of Anambra State, Chief Willie Ebele.
How do you feel today as the Commissioner?
I feel great, but more importantly, I feel prepared for the work ahead. It's a great responsibility, and first of all, I'd like to thank God for giving us this opportunity, because without the gift of life, none of us would be here today. Secondly, I'd like to thank my family, my wife, my mom, my sisters, my cousins, my in-laws, represented by my wife's mom today, because they provided the platform. If you're not happy at home, you can never deliver at work. So it's extremely important that they were here today to give me that support that they've always given me. But thirdly, I'd like to thank my colleagues who I've worked with for the last 2 years and 3 months in Anambra State Government in various capacities. My senior colleagues, they've been very supportive and ensured that we've continued to stay in touch with our plan for the state to transform Anambra State's fortunes and to leave a better state for our children. But last but not the least, I'd like to give all thanks to His Excellency, the Governor of Anambra State. He's a man of many firsts. He's the first governor to make Anambra the safest state in Nigeria. He's also the first governor to make Anambra the most educational friendly state. He's also the first governor to make Anambra the most investment friendly state in this country. And now, he's shown by this singular act that he's probably, not probably, he is the most progressive governor Nigeria knows and the most youth-friendly governor. It's not easy to give youth an opportunity, but today he has showed with his faith in him that he's ready to support youth and support talent where he finds it could be. I'd like to also note and let us know that Anambra State is the only state with 55% of our political appointees being youth between the ages of 18 and 35. So it deserves good commendation. And for me, this is an opportunity. I've seen discussions going on social media platforms about how I am carrying the Nigerian youth everywhere in the world on my shoulders. It's a great responsibility, but I'd like to assure them, but more importantly, assure His Excellency of my dedication, my commitment, my loyalty to the cause in Anambra State, and I'll do everything I can, as I've always done before, but now to do it a lot more, to turn around the fortunes of our state and to take us to greater heights. It's a clear indication by His Excellency to Nigeria that the youth have a place in governance, they have a place in the public sector, and they have a place in giving back to our country. We have seen scenarios where in Scotland, I believe, where an 18-year-old lady was voted in as an MP. And we also understand that right now, even the federal legislators are taking steps to reduce the minimum age for participation of youth in governance in Nigeria. So I think this is one of those classic cases where His Excellency has done it and has bit everybody to it by giving the youth an opportunity, thereby giving me an opportunity. And I see it as an opportunity for other youths in Nigeria to know that Nigeria is work in progress, and as each day passes and we continue to get better and move in the right direction, His Excellency has shown it by this appointment, and I think it's for me to ensure that I don't disappoint, because I know the world will be watching, Nigeria will be watching. If I do get it right, then it opens up numerous opportunities for other youths in Nigeria, and if I do get it wrong, then it completely closes it out, and it's a discussion for another day. But that's where God is important, and that's where your innate desire to work hard and to ensure you give back to the state and deliver on all your responsibilities and the mandates of this new position.